This is CNN Breaking News.
Let's get right to the breaking news tonight. An official in Iraq now says ISIS is behind a deadly suicide car bombing in a city that's been relatively secure until now. The terror group on the attack near a key base for American forces, even as new U.S.-led airstrikes are targeting ISIS fighters. 30 attacks have been launched over the past 72 hours in Iraq and in Syria. By the way, we're getting new information about the war against ISIS and the threat to Americans. The State Department's deputy spokeswoman, Marie Harf, she's standing by, along with our correspondents, our analysts. They're covering all the stories that are breaking right now. First, let's go to our chief national security correspondent, Jim Sciutto, with the very latest. Jim?
Well, what's concerning here is that to this point, Erbil has been different. You visit there, it is wealthier, it is more organized, and crucially, it is safer. And in large part because of that very fact, there are 75 U.S. military advisors based there, some 200 diplomats, many more American businessmen and officials who travel to Erbil on a regular basis. Perhaps most importantly, it is the base for the Kurdish forces that are fighting alongside the U.S. against ISIS. Today, however, ISIS demonstrated its ability to penetrate some of the best security in the country. It has been an oasis of relative security in war-torn Iraq, but today ISIS brought terror to the streets of Erbil. A suicide car bomb detonating at the entrance of a government building, killing at least 4 people and wounding another 29. The Kurdish stronghold is one of 2 main bases for U.S. military advisors in Iraq, and the site of a visit earlier this week by Joint Chiefs Chairman General Martin Dempsey. Today, General Dempsey acknowledged that the U.S. strategy for fighting ISIS is under constant review.
We have a strategy, but here's what I'll tell you about that strategy. It's going to change. It's going to change often. The objective is not going to change, but I'm not obsessing so much about what's in the middle, because the middle is going to change.
ISIS's latest violent video showing the death of American Peter Kasich is now yielding new clues. French authorities have identified 2 citizens, Maxime Hochard and Mikhail Dos Santos, as among the ISIS fighters seen slaughtering a dozen men, described as Syrian military pilots. Already, hundreds of Westerners, including about a dozen Americans, are known to have joined ISIS or attempted to. The group's remarkable recruiting overseas, so far uninterrupted by the U.S.-led war.
They could be from any background, from any ethnic origin, but they easily can be brainwashed into becoming converts. And this is a very important matter. We must be vigilant.
President Obama has so far failed to seek new congressional authority to defeat ISIS. Questioned by senators at his confirmation hearing today, Deputy Secretary of State nominee Tony Blinken said the White House would introduce legislation if it can pass Congress.
We would like to have a targeted, focused AUMF that deals with the challenge before us, which is defeating ISIL. If we can get an AUMF that gets broad support, there's no question we will be better off.
Regarding today's bombing in Erbil, a senior U.S. military official tells me, quote, we have no information to indicate that U.S. personnel were being specifically targeted in this attack. And just as a matter of reference, the U.S. consulate is some 2.5 miles from the location of today's bombing. But the real concern here, Wolf, is about ISIS's capability. It had shown it can strike with regularity inside the capital, Baghdad. Now it has shown it can strike in Erbil as well.
Yeah, very worrisome development indeed. Jim Sciutto, thanks very much. Now the view from the ground in this war against ISIS. Let's go to our senior international correspondent, Nick Payton-Walsh. He's right near the border of Syria and Turkey. What's the latest there?
Well, Wolf, as regards that attack, we know that 4 were killed as a suicide car bomber attempted to get near the governorate inside of Erbil. An official also telling me 29 people were injured. Among the dead, though, police officers who saw this vehicle try and approach the governorate's gate, it seems opened fire and then lost their lives in the subsequent explosion. That, of course, sending shockwaves across Erbil, literally as well as emotionally too, as Jim was saying. This city, which has been not immune to the violence, but certainly significantly more prosperous, distant from the front line, about an hour's drive away, a lot more violence around Kirkuk, where they have in the last 24 24 hours, been a lot of U.S. airstrikes in support of Kurdish moves against ISIS around there. This blast certainly making many concerned that ISIS may have a new capability to penetrate inside the more secure areas the Kurds and the Peshmerga have in northern Iraq. Wolf?
As you know, the fighting is continuing not far away from where you are. And U.S. Retired General John Allen, he's the man in charge of coordinating this expanding coalition against ISIS. He was in Turkey today. What can you tell us about that visit?
A somewhat brief visit in Ankara, the capital, meeting comparatively lower level foreign ministry officials, and then the Turkish foreign ministry announced he quite swiftly went on to Brussels, the next stop on his trip here. Now, you bear in mind too the backdrop to this visit. We don't precisely know what's on the table, but certainly the US very keen to get its hands on more facilities here in the southern Turkish area. But it came as President Erdogan repeated the position that Turkey wasn't really willing to budge on its contribution to the fight against ISIS unless it had its conditions more closely met. And they want the focus really to be less ISIS, more about finding a solution in the eyes of Turkey for the Syrian regime with President Bashar al-Assad effectively removing it, but also establishing a no-fly zone in the north of Syria. That is a key thing Turkey wants to see, to allow perhaps some refugees back in, to slow what they see as the slaughter of civilians by the regime air force in northern Syria too, and eventually give them effectively a security buffer zone before the Turkish border. Increasingly volatile month by month here, Wolf.